What's going on? There we go. Man, it took me a minute to set that up. Whatever. But production right now, I am going on a hiatus, so I'm going to take a business trip. Right now, with everything that's going on in here, as soon as I saw one problem, another one occurs because I need one thing in order for something else to work. And I keep coming back in here. I come in here, I spend a day in here trying to do one thing, solve that, realize I need something else to make this even better because there's something else that is needed. Yeah. So I decided that I need to go all in and go take a little business vacation. I'm probably going to be gone for a few weeks, maybe all of this month. I only came in here to clean up and freeze my milk. Because the other day I just left this place in tatters. Like, my EZ2 DJ computer board in here died. I got it somewhere around here. Yeah, this is it right here. Yeah, EZ2 DJ board. It just suddenly died on me. This is an ancient board. This game is very, very specific about what it takes. So, on eBay, like the most affordable board is $1,000. All right. I gotta go to Akihabara or Abiba, however you pronounce it, and take a risk on buying one of their motherboards from China. Luckily, that's $78, but my mileage may vary because it can be a dud. It can work and that's cool, or it can be a dud and that's a problem. All right. So, yeah, $1,000, and the reason why is usually with some of these you can just find any motherboard and replace it easily. But what makes this one particular is this ISA slot right here. This is basically the I/O for the whole DJ deck. Without this, I'm not gonna get any damn gameplay. The game will run, it's just I can't use the turntable or anything that's the whole function of the game. So, a computer board that came out pretty much, what, 95, 96, 97, probably back then, cost maybe $100. Maybe two, probably doing the mid 2000s, these things probably like $20, maybe a $5. And in this day and age of today, with all the boards and technology we got, these things like the cheapest I found was $500. Well, I had the ISA slot, it didn't have the PCI card. It's like these things will have one thing or the other, and not the other. It's A or B. Found one on that website from China. They got both. I gotta take a risk. I really, really don't want to. I try to contact the people that I got it from, but they're already in deep water with all the production and stuff they're behind on, and they only talk on Twitter, or at least the guy that I got it from the company, Square Pixel, is only communicating through Twitter, which is just great. I got a few boards in here, like this one. This is a Gigabyte, looks new. And yeah, this is what the new Gigabyte board that I had works. No sound. And that's, looked it up, saying there were sound problems with this. Bought this forever ago. At some point, me just having it around, never using it, and not having it protected, this broke. So, putting that up. I really need a box for all of these. Got some locks from a partner in Reno. Yeah, because this desk right in here is messy. Got the capture card, my second one, for old games like Pump It Up Pro, NBA Jam, and DDR. While it works, I need something for the sound. And while the plug for the sound costs like 12 bucks, most likely I'm gonna need myself a mixer. Like a mixer to make the whole sound quality sounds good without any lag. I tried doing the sound input to the desktop, and while it came out good, the delay was about 30 seconds. And I'm sure that I can figure it out and play around with it, but with the amount of time just getting the sound from A to B took me like 3 hours the other day, and it's just frustrating. Well, at least now I know what I'm doing. So that is good. I think that's a positive, that's a plus. This can still be used. So, parts. What's also a trip is I still haven't replaced the Easy2 DJ screen. But no point in me replacing the screen when the damn motherboard took a crap on me, and it sucks. And this is without my bills. I got taxes, haven't even filed my taxes. I got a call to people today to see if I can file now or file today before I skip town for God knows how long. Yeah, that's another thing. Besides coming up here for the milk to put in the freezer, I came in here to grab one of my internet bill to make sure I pay it, because I'm a month behind on it. And that's fine. I got to the 21st. I gotta eat all my fruit before it spoils. Oh man, it's starting to dry out. Whatever, I deal with it. Thank you. myself now I'm doing that once. I didn't really help things. But I haven't really been focused on it. Haven't been really focused on anything. I've been trying to balance everything. But the only thing I need to do now, I just need to do my taxes for last year. I need to review that. I hope I don't have to owe that much. I mean, my 2017 taxes, I decided to pay it like last month, and that took a dent out of my money. Oh yeah, just found a penny. Use this jug to save coins. No gameplay. Not yet. Maybe in a month. Right now, I just don't know. Hell, I'm hoping I can come back from the business trip safe. I'm not recording this. Probably do need to record this. No, I am recording. Cool. Yeah. Bought a new 8 terabyte hard drive. Haven't even used it. Hoping to take out the hard drive, put it in the computer, or use it to build another computer in this place. Like, I'm really, really tired of just moving my PC from one area to another whenever I need to use it. Like, I want a computer in here, I need a computer in there. Because right now, just carrying it, moving it back and forth, it's annoying. So many plugs involved. So many. So many. What I'm hoping. What I'm hoping to have when I come back is the ability to have wires set up throughout the whole place. So I won't need to keep unplugging it, moving all these wires back and forth. And, you know, doing it again whenever I go from one cab to another. The only thing I want to move is the mic and the camera. All right, mic, camera, that's it. Nothing more, nothing less. And that's another thing. I gotta set up the mic on the ceilings. I feel like it will be easier that way. stuff, the mic, the wires. So to go through the ceiling, just have it surrounded this whole place. Because right now, at least how the mic is set up, which is just on the floor, it captures just too much noise. I mean, I know you can set that up. I looked it up and found it. But I would like it to have it above me. Oh, can I rotate this camera up? No, whatever. So, not sure you can see. But up there, got some outlets. Some hooks from the previous renters, and something going all over there in that corner over there. I don't know. But what I'm hoping is to have basically, at least for the mic, you know, set up, at least for the wires, there's hooks up there. I can add some more hooks, get myself like maybe, set up with some wood. Set up woods on each side, so where DDR and Pump It Up is. Set up some wood, like a piece of wood coming down just for the camera. I'm hoping to have a table right here, just for the PC and the production of stuff. I'm hoping to have wires just going through. You know, have one for this pump, that DDR, as well as Dan's Evo and Keyboard Mania. That's what I want to do. And I believe it can work. It'll be much easier. I won't have, you know, wires down here all over the place. Like, that's my internet cable, you know, next to the giant love sack. That cable was way back there. While I was doing testing on the Pump It Up, and I just don't want to move it no more. Just don't. Tired moving stuff. But I'm hoping with the business trip, it goes good. And I'm hoping it goes good at this point. Because I really, 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 really need a break. But if it goes good, yep. I can really start doing real work in here. Like, I won't need to come in here for a couple hours, leave, and then come back 2 or 3 days later, or even a week later. Like, I work too damn much. And I haven't been breaking even. I've been losing money. been getting worse, like, each and, like, every year. And I would like to change that. So, I would like to change that. I would like to get more games in here. Or however many games I can fit in here. Oh, there goes that penny. Because the way he's looking now, none of this stuff is, everything looking like a big, is a wasting time. And the only way I can pull this off, like, one, give myself a break. And two, make some sacrifices for the next maybe few weeks, maybe month. To get the handles and stuff that I need to handle so I can get this ball rolling. Because there's still a lot of stuff that I need. And for the moment, as far as getting stuff, I am on my own. I can't go and get a loan. I don't want to get a loan. I want to use credit cards. You know, I'd rather be in the basically just flat zero nothing than being red every month. Because even with the credit cards and all that, I still got my college loan that I still got to pay for. While paying for all this and trying to get new games. College loan alone is $600 a month. I want to at least drop $1,000 a month on it. Maybe 1,500. But at the moment, with everything going on, especially with that coming back in, because I keep on deferring it, telling myself, okay, I'm going to handle all these other stuff first. And then all this other stuff happens, and then end up not getting handled. The debt increases, and the more it sits, the more I let it sit and do nothing about it, the higher it gets. And I don't want to defer it no more. I mean, it's already bad enough according to the loan contract. It'll probably, if I keep paying the minimum balance, maybe I might be done by the time I'm 68. Maybe. That's just how it works. I don't got no family stress for once. I gotta go visit my mom later. Maybe I might tell her I'm going out of town. I'm gonna tell my pops. Because he always need me because, he teaching me the business. No, he's teaching me the business. I got responsibilities, I got people that rely on me. So, yeah, I also gotta go visit my pops. I gotta go visit the property over there, clean up. We did some work over there. Fill up trash cans, or fill up the green trash cans. I gotta go back there and finish it. Street Fighter the movie sometime. Maybe after I get an arcade stick for the Saturn. Or Night Warriors. But a show is coming. I want one that where I can put my 100% focus on, not worry about running the streets and being on the grind. If this was 4 years ago, I mean, this would be easy because, well, the only thing I'll have is just my student loan. And that's it. But then again, I wouldn't have all these machines. All these machines that I have, I paid for all of them. Probably set the DDR cab over there, the black one, with cash. Just hard work, patience, and time, and cash. Easy. I got Ninja Turtles, I got Simpsons. What I wanted to do was put this on top of the Konami cab over there where Sunset Riders is. If you haven't seen it, it's over there. You can probably see it. Like, I want to mount it on there because I got the Simpsons. I had Turtles in Time, gave it away, because I figure at some point I want to dedicate a cab solo by itself. It's going to cost me like a grand or a grand, grand 200. I don't mind paying it, because when I bought the board, it was broken and I paid less than 100 bucks for it. And now the board alone is like 500. And the cabinet is another $500 to $700 extra after that. But yeah, this, I haven't had this probably since I was 17. No, 18. Now I'm sure I can show you. It says copyright, 2002. So I'm about to put this up here. Been trying to let myself get relaxed. But not easy trying to juggle all these things. And I'm overdue for a vacation. Like a real, real vacation. I gotta be 2 years behind, maybe three. Well, like, just a trip. trip where I'm like doing something business related. One thing for sure, I gotta go to the Nolia for my family reunion. And maybe DDR Storm. Maybe. But before I take any trips, I need to make sure what I'm doing down here, everything is handled. Everything. I want to handle this. While this table's cool, I want to be able to move the TV, because I might just do my little stretch workouts right behind on that rug right there, but I want like a table, not a table, but more like, I guess it's a table or something with wheels for, so I can move this back and forth. My couch that I had in here, at least one of them, it's not here at the moment. It was right here. It was a nice place to sit and play and do the damn thing. I also was about to buy myself a bike little rack for this. I just want to hook it to the wall, set that up in the back here, just hook it to the wall, because this is pretty much in the way right now. Some old beat up legs from a pump it up pad I had that I gave to my girlfriend. Useless. Beat up. I'm probably never going to use these, but it's always nice to have just in case. I need to get myself a C battery for the Saturn so I can save stuff. Thank you. computer boards, place this with it. Electronic toolbox, this handle. Going up. Water. Oh, this ain't gonna fit. Yeah, this board still works. Grab this box up here. Shoes real quick. Might lay DDR on them. I got so mad my shoes last night for being butter on the pads. It's very, very frustrating. Like, so frustrating. Yeah, but I keep forgetting I got shoes up here that I hardly worn. Coming out of the ladder, always risky. Yeah, since this board down here still works, maybe someone might be interested in an old MK6 computer. I'll probably use it as a giveaway when this channel starts, so I can take in viewers, build a little cult following. Gotta put milk up. Also read that it's better, well, I heard it's better to have these things in plastic. I'm doing it this way. I got no plastic around. Not for this thing. I'm gonna put this in here too. Because after I eat some cereal, all right. Yeah, it's just very unfortunate that this board right here from 1994, 1995, or yeah, 94, from like 94 to 97. Can't find them. like that while paying some money for it. And I only found out when I took it to a shop last week. They tried to save it. They couldn't save it. I was sad. This Straskin right here is such a... more like a recycling type of bin than anything. I mean, like a regular Straskin, anything. Yeah, like all the Straskins in here, I only pay for one. This, I got this from a move from a clothing company that was moving. This one from a job the other day. Simpsons, putting out the Simpsons and the Turtles toys. I got this from Comic-Con. Only time I went there, had to grab this. At least for me, it was a requirement. I couldn't get no pops. I mean, the only pop I wanted back then was the Powerpuff Girls. But you needed not only a ticket, but you needed to meet at some secret location behind some church. Couldn't do all that. thing I want in here, I'm hoping to get a Guitar Freaks and a Drum Mania. And probably, if not, just I'll be happy with the Guitar Freaks. I'll play that. And maybe some Velixes. Probably two. I want to play Tetris Attack, or I should say Tetris Grandmaster. And maybe some fighting games on there. Hopefully. All in the plans. I just need to handle this stuff in here first. No, bills first, then this. There's gonna be some days where I'm not even sure I'm gonna be able to shower. Do shower. I use this. It works. But I'm probably gonna need a little bit more than that. There's only 8 wipes in there. I need to pay 24-hour business. I was gonna try to fight with them this year, but since I'm about to take this, gonna have to pay the bill. So my sleeper arrangement is unknown. I'm gonna grab some pork stuff I got back here. Yesterday, I was about to go take my bike out for a ride. Not this bike. I got a bike over in LA. And my pump was up here. Speaking of pump, I don't know where the pump that's supposed to be up here is. I know I used it not that long ago to pump this bike right here. Where I put that bike? That bike pump. Back here? Walmart last night, bought the pump. I was holding the bike today, but I wanted to come in here. I still got time to bike. Maybe in the later evenings if I haven't already hit the road. But haven't been biking like I wanted. I had an unfortunate crash back in December where my shoulder just got destroyed. You know, I slid on the ground and my right shoulder. Yeah, right shoulder took all a lot of the my bump. Like, I was traveling downhill. I looked on my phone. It was on his mount. Didn't see this crack on the road that potentially was a pothole in the making. Hit the sweet spot of it. Now, since I got these regular pedals, not the one with the clips. If I had clips, maybe I would have flew, maybe not. Maybe I would have gained control of the bike. However, since there is no clips, the second I bounced, legs went up. Try to put my feet down the pedal, that ain't happening. Flew. Flip forward. Who was texting me? Yeah, but flew off the bike, flipped. Mind you that I wasn't even wearing a shirt, but I was wearing a helmet. Safety. Flip. Right shoulder. Just on the concrete. Or I should say the pavement. The road pavement. Bike flips. My hand, not wearing gloves. Take the second part to take a whole bunch of force as I'm crashing on the ground. Bike flips, bounce off my head, which I was wearing a helmet. Well, now it's 100% recovered. This hand, hole. Big hole. This hand, a little hole. Wrist gone, me all bloody, and I still kept riding. This crash happened within the first 3 miles, and I still had another 17 to go to the destination I was going to. Instead of turning back, I went to the CVS. Got all the band-aids and Neosporin up. Team riding, I was just riding fries to see if they had a part. They didn't. On top of that, my dad told me to get out of this house that he was about to rent. So it was a nice combination of things that happened all at once on that day. Oh man, it was so bad. So much pain.
show on the road.
Yeah, I probably gotta get maybe a 3 foot 4x4. Let's have it right here. But this is what I'm just picturing right now. Have USB cords, at least. Just to be safe, 50 feet. Let's have 50 foot cords. Just around the whole facility. What I'm really, really thinking, that only a few games will need, I think the only game right now that will need, cores and stuff in the middle is the pump, and whatever game I get next that I want in the middle. I mean, I'm gonna have my couch here back whenever my pop is done with it. I'm hoping to get a sleeper couch so I can rest in between shows, because I wanna do multiple shows. I wanna do, the minimum is 3 hours, with the max being 8 to 12. I got enough games in here to bounce around from one game to another. And that's what I want to do when I'm in here. This is probably the second or third longest show at the moment. Second or third. I also want to weigh these shoes. I take off one thing, I bring down another. Heater's not needed because out here in California, Southern California, we are back to our desert conditions, which I like. I am a lizard. I need my sun on me at all times, period. Not this whole wet weather thing that people were so glad to have. No, for the moment, I can't handle the cold, which has actually stopped me from going to do a career job in DC. I got offered a job to be a librarian. I just had to go to DC, and I will need to be, just to be sure that I can get back to California, I will need to be in DC for like 2 to 3 years minimum. And I said no, couldn't do it. There's no way. Well, I went out there for MAGFest in 2018, and that win. It wasn't. I guess it was warmer this year than it was previous year. But the wind alone, like the second you get into the single digits, I can't do it. I can't do it. And the folks out there who were just in bikini no shirt and just like, yo, this ain't shit. I don't know how they do it. I mean, I know they were born, they're used to it, but I couldn't do it. Just can't. I also couldn't deal with the whole taxis. Like, man, straight up a ripoff.
That's up there.
Computer boards and stuff up here.
Yeah, I need a place to put my recyclables. Guess the trash can will do it now. But yeah, production in here. As I said some time ago, it's on hiatus until further notice. I want to be able to do what I want to do, especially in here, because right now this is month 4. In the 4 months I've been here, at least not doing something on my phone, it's only been like, it took me 3 months. When things should have been, you know, running probably after the first 2 months. It's okay to be behind schedule. It happens. Not everything is under control, or at least not everyone can have things under their control. Who is texting me? Okay. I gotta answer this. I got to answer this text. This is from a job that I did the other day that it took 5 minutes. Basically, I needed to move a 200-pound refrigerator. Spoiler alert, wasn't 200 pounds. Off a pallet, move it to the back, push it to the back of the wall. Took 5 minutes. The job sat there for so long that no one took it. So when they finally gave it to me, I just, all right. I didn't pay attention to it because I thought I was just doing this by myself. Went in, did it, left. Apparently, I had someone else coming with me. Didn't know it. I thought I was by myself. And now the company is hitting me up saying, hey, this person didn't show up. What happened? So I got to explain how I, because this is my screw, I didn't check to see if I had a partner. I thought I didn't have no partner because the job sat there for 2 days and no one took it. And explained to them that, yeah, he was on his way. And then I'm pretty sure he found out that he wasn't needed from the job getting completed by me. So this is going to take a second, maybe like a few minutes. So because the question was, Phil, we received a report that Mark didn't show up for this particular job number. Can you provide some clarification? Did he show up? And I have to tell him. So there was some confusion on my part. I did not know I had Mark as a partner or any partner at all. I am sure he was on his way to the home or to the job site when I got there. Job took 5 minutes. I did it and left. I got there. Got there 30 minutes early. The job took 5 minutes. And I left. So I just gave him some clarification because this was on me. I still say he should get money or a few bucks for his drive because it's not like he got a car. This dude's on a little moped bike. So I'm pretty sure he didn't know what the hell was going on until I got to the gate. Until he got to the gate and realized, hey, this job is done. And just left. I mean, it didn't matter anyway. Technically, Mark, this guy that I worked for, is borderline useless. As far as moving. Because, yeah, he's just not good at lifting people. Work on your lower back, work on your core. It'll make life a whole lot easier for you in the long run. Please. Lower back, your core, work on your quads. You know, having a chest is nice, but if you can't sit there, you can't bend your back, you're not going to get far. Especially if you're doing stuff physical. If you're sitting in a chair all day too, especially that, you might want to do some stretches. Oh yeah, so what's going to go on with the show whenever it starts? So shows like this early in the morning is what I call it. I'm trying to decide between the wake up show. I used to be a big fan of the old school 90s underground hip hop show with Sway and Tech, the wake up show. It used to come on late at night on 92.3 The Beat before it jumped to Power 106. Before Sway decided to go solo with Biz Move, Mega Move for MTV, maybe there's more to that story that I don't know about. I was also thinking of That's My Neighbor, The Woke Show. Man, these notifications. What's going on here now? Okay. This is the lady I'm trying to get the motherboard from. So let's see, what's going on? I found my careless mistake. I had quarter price was EXW price, but I forgot to add the EXW. I don't know what that means. Because at the time, I stayed with my two babies in the car back to hometown for tomb sweeping, and then back to Shenzhen. She's in China. Hope my explain can be got your forgiveness. And now I have to consult your freight calls by DHL for you. So the motherboard. So the price is $78. And I guess just for one piece is, or I guess the shipping price is $28. Whatever. I'll pay what I need to pay. I need to get the game. Okay, notification. I'm going to have to cut you off. Is this another message from her? God dang it. Are you here now? I'll be waiting for you because I find the mistake about the price. I want to explain in time. I got it. I am here. $78. For motherboard, $28. Put that dollar sign for shipping total six. $106. $106, god dang it. I I should have bought more than one. $106, right? Alright. Notification, you gotta... I'm gonna put you on low. As I figured, this trash can here with these recyclables is not gonna work. Chocolate peanuts for the road. Also gonna be taking this baby with me. Hydro Flask, 128 ounces. Hoping to find some water stations out there. Probably go to Whole Foods or something to fill up. Just a bag of parts. Oh yeah, this is deodorant block. Hey, been looking for you. 28.9, 38.9. Okay. I'm gonna use the restroom. Video card I haven't used yet. Seems like I got a message from her again. Yep. Okay. That's the right price because alone in her trip, I was ill. But now I feel much better. Thank you for your forgiveness. And I have not waited for a long time. Yeah, I'm hoping to get that next week. Because we gotta get started. God damn it. These motherfuckers took money from me. I barely. If I know better, I think they just took my tit from me. So. This is very confusing. Dolly earnings. Yeah, I had to pause for a moment. I'm looking at my earnings. I ain't earned that much last week on the truck drunk. God damn it. Phil, in the future, please pay attention to the dolly so that we do not have this confusion again. Dolly has been modified, so you are only paid for the work of one helper. Partner, even though he's useless, he should get paid for traveling. He didn't know. He was on a bike. Yes, go to sleep, lady. Thank you. ready to call today's show a wrap? So, whoever's watching this or whatever, no show, no games today. Gonna be going on a business trip. It's about to hit 9, you know, I'm gonna stay on for until 9 p.m. Pacific time, or Los Angeles time for sure. It's now 8:52 a.m. I got a long few weeks ahead of me. Maybe it won't be so long. Maybe it might be all right. I don't know. It's just things have been so unpredictable. And I would like to get things, back, just back in order. Let's see. Amy, thank you. Stop typing. Okay. Whatever, Dolly. Whatever. Oh, man. Yeah, one of the main reasons why I'm going on a hiatus trip, or going on this business trip, because, I mean, I said it earlier, I want to handle all my stuff, but mainly, I want to get out the grind, or not grind as much. Like, I'm going back and forth. I got one company, GoShare, bunch of assholes. I can't say a bunch of assholes, just the CEO. Just the CEO is an asshole. Because I called him one. Because he decided not to give me my money. When I called him out on stuff. So, I gotta get ready for that. You know, I gotta get ready for that. I got this company, Dolly, another truck driving app. It's complicated. Yeah, it's really, really complicated. Sometimes, odd. Like, right now I'm dealing with two cases. The first case involves a customer who went from, hey, this chair is cheap, to, oh, snap, this chair got stolen. This is the most expensive chair ever. I need to report this stuff. And we got, and that's the situation. And I'm not even sure how this is going to end. I got another dude who pretty much broke his doorknob or door handle during the move because we were putting a refrigerator in. I gave him the question, like, is this going to fit through the door? While it went through the door, he did not think about door handle. And when he forced it in, door handle broke. We couldn't even put it back in. I'm talking to him about it. He's like, hey, okay, look, don't worry about this. I'll handle this. I'll talk to the landlord about it. I said, okay, left. The kid even tipped me. 2 months later, I'm getting a damage claim, and I'm telling the company, like, at this point, I can't sit, at least with the company, like, I can't even sit there and explain what really went down, because any way it goes, they're going go with the customer over the worker. I'm just a mook. You know, I'm just, they never met me. They don't know who I am. They weren't there at the situation. These are no more than some kids, tiny little kids, who probably can't even lift like a 10-pound dumbbell that's overseas, us people, workers, laborers, who are breaking our backs to make them rich. It's going to, hands down, kiss the customer's behind to make sure they are satisfied and no trouble comes from this. Oh man, it was so interesting with the item that got stolen, because usually it would be like somebody's fault, the worker's fault, but part of it was my partner's fault, but the main person at fault was the brother who's supposed to be the lookout. He's supposed to be the lookout. All he needed to do was, it's four of us. The customer, the sister, is upstairs being in our home. We move, she's on the fifth floor. We move stuff downstairs to the first floor. While we're moving stuff to my truck, which is parked in the front, my partner made the decision to say, hey, let's just get all this stuff outside. And I told him specifically that that's crazy. In probably the suburbs, you can do that stuff. You're talking about the streets of K-Town. Streets of K-Town, you put something on the side of the road and look even somewhat decent, someone's going to jack it. Or someone's going to think it's junk and take it. But yeah, we put a bed frame and a chair outside next to my truck. All we needed to do was just throw it in there. And I think no one would have touched it. Go back upstairs. We unload everything else. Instead of putting it up front, I was like, yo, we're going to put this in the hallway. All right, we're going to put it in the hallway. Meanwhile, the stuff that's outside, which was a bed frame and chair, still in place. And I straight gave, and they told me what I'm doing, like, you know, why you put it, you know, in the hallway where we should have left it. And I told the brother who's supposed to be on the lookout, like, look, you know, we can't just leave this out here, man. You can't just leave. You put all this stuff out here, so we're going to just take it like that. You know what area you're in? It's K-Town. Like, people leave stuff on the side of the road all the time because they can't get rid of it. It can't fit in a trash can. Someone else takes it, or some homeless person takes it, because that's a bed to them. Or that is some potential furniture to flip and sell to some people for however, whatever price you want to sell it for. The little brother decided to tell me that, look, no one's not going to touch this. No one's not going to take it. He sees it as junk. I straight told him in his face that, like, look, dude, I'll take this stuff, dude. It looks too clean. If the metal was all beat up, broken, you know, the chair had all kind of stains in it, if it didn't look fresh or new, didn't have a nice color to it because it was purple-ish, then yeah, dude, I'll believe you. People will think this is junk. It shows how he thought of his sister shit. Or I should say sister stuff. Junk. What happened after that? Stuff still outside. We go upstairs. My partner got to take apart the table in order to get it out. Dismantling the table wasn't part of the job. look, I'm going back downstairs. Start loading up because, you know, I don't feel right just leaving that stuff down there. Because the brother who's supposed to be on the lookout, who decided to be a little puppy, decided to follow me and my partner like up and down the elevator. So I go down, I look outside, bed frame been moved, chair is gone. Step outside to see. Some Latino cat in an SUV already pulled up. He loaded up the chair. About to get ready to put the bed frame on top of his vehicle. I straight up yell like, hey, that's mine. Went outside, took the bed frame back. Had to sit there and call the customer. Actually, I had to call my partner to tell him like, look, you need to tell her that the chair is gone. Like, someone took the chair, someone took the bed frame. It's gone. This girl, this customer, we're from, this chair is cheap, and I don't care about it, to, oh my God, this chair is so expensive. Call the cops, trying to file a robbery. All they did was just laugh at her. Like, the cops just looked at me, they chuckle at me. I'm trying not to laugh because this is business. But they look at her, explain to her that, yo, it's a chair. It's on the sidewalk. This girl is trying to explain to them who would think this is junk? Who would sit here and take it? And, you know, the cops and me just she's clueless. You know, she's clueless. And my partner, I'm like, oh, man, he's confused. I'm like, how are you this clueless, man? Like, people see stuff on the side of the road, it's not going to last. And it looks good. It's not going to last no more than 5 minutes. Now here in L.A., especially in a place like K-Town where it's oversaturated with people, people putting stuff out there on the street every day for anybody to take. Was one person's junk is another person's treasure. So after she called the cops and they came and laughed at her because that's what you do. The fact that she didn't know how things work in that area already made her feel pretty dumb. And my partner is doing whatever he can possible to talk her, like, you know, trying to give her a couch. What this girl sees now, she's not looking at it as, oh, I just lost some cheap chair. I lost an expensive chair. And see an opportunity to flip. And when I mean by flip, I mean flip and give straight up profit for some chair that she probably didn't pay for or probably paid $20 for. A $20 chair just became $300 to $500 instantly. So I already knew what's up. Because she wasn't talking to my partner no more after this whole experience. He tried to give her the chair, and I already knew what was going to happen. Because this is the first time this ever happened. And now, out of nowhere, the brother, who's supposed to be on the lookout, he's unaccounted for. And we're explaining to them, like, yo, the brother's supposed to be on the lookout. He chose to keep following us. The sister even said it to him after everything went down. But now, since the cops laughed at her and she wasn't going to get no stuff back, she turned to us what can the company do? Company got no choice but to pretty much put us at fault, because that's what's gonna happen. Because this is the first time this has ever happened. Because there's no explanation. I've done 1,000 moves by now in the last almost 2 years since I've been doing this. This is the first time that something like this has ever happened. Only because I'm smart enough not to leave stuff on the sidewalk. And while I'm throwing my partner under the bus about it, the sister is majorly at fault, because the brother should have been the lookout. We're not going to gang rape your sister. Okay, stop following us. All right? Stay down here. Watch the stuff. You sitting here laughing that no one's not going to touch it. No one's not going to take it. I'm sitting here telling you, dog, someone's going to take this. All right? I'm giving you a warning. Okay? Hey. But that happened. Now the company going back and forth with the customer, because the customer is already shady. You know, all of a sudden it's an expensive item when you were selling us as a cheap one in an apartment that you didn't care about it. That's jacked up. But anyway, oh man, it's already 9:09. I gotta end this. This place is looking a lot cleaner than when I started with, but I'm still gonna be cleaning afterwards. But, oh god dang it. Well, I'm stopping this now. Whoever watching, thank you. Alright. Whoever watching later, thanks for the view. Okay. I'll be back soon.